In this lecture, we will learn about childhood diarrheas or gastroenteritis. Gastroenteritis is one of the most common conditions affecting the children, more so in the economically poor communities. WHO, the World Health Organization, gives top priority to the prevention and treatment of gastroenteritis. Yet, globally, nearly 2 million deaths occur per year due to gastroenteritis. And all these deaths are easily preventable by administration of proper treatment. The family physician has a very important role to play in the treatment of gastroenteritis, not only by administering medicines and fluids, but by educating all the ladies and mothers who come with their children about proper, clean, sterile feeding and oral rehydration. Gastroenteritis mainly affects children below 5 years, and the maximum affection is in infants between 6 months to 2 years. In infants, gastroenteritis starts with fever and watery loose motions. It may be associated with vomiting, and the child becomes rapidly dehydrated. Initially, the child becomes thirsty, drinks eagerly, the tongue and mouth are dry, it is restless and irritable, crying, the eyes are slightly sunken, and the skin, when pinched, goes back slowly. Later, in severe dehydration, the child becomes lethargic, drowsy, or sometimes unconscious. The eyes are deeply sunken, tongue and mouth are totally dry, and skin turgor is lost. When pinched, skin remains pinched for a long time. The treatment of gastroenteritis is described in 3 plans according to the degree of dehydration. If there are no signs of dehydration, then treatment plan A is started. The child is managed at home with ORS and home available fluids. Instruct the mother to feed ORS continuously as much as the baby takes, except when there is vomiting or abdominal distension. Give 100 ml of ORS after every watery stool. You all know how to prepare ORS. There are several commercial preparations of ORS available in sachet form, like Electral, Raylite, etc. Boil and keep 1 to 2 liters of water. Take 200 ml of boiled and cooled water in a clean glass and add 1 sachet of ORS to it. For poor patients, it can be prepared by taking 200 ml of boiled and cooled water and adding a teaspoonful of sugar and a pinch of salt. The child is very thirsty and will drink it eagerly. The mother should keep on feeding the ORS as much as the baby demands. Mothers often worry about 2 things, that the child is drinking too much water and that the water is just flowing down the stools. You must explain that it is the other way around, that what is lost in the stools is being replaced and that the child needs it. Gastroenteritis is undoubtedly a test of patience for the mother. The child is irritable, sleeps less, asks for only the mother, and the mother has to sit by the child day and night. The ordeal continues for 3 to 7 days, even with all our treatment. But the mother has to do it. There is no alternative. Now about breastfeeding. Breastfeeding should always be continued during acute diarrhea. If baby is on top milk, that too should continue. Milk feeding may slightly increase the frequency of stools, but it does not increase dehydration. Feeding milk helps mucosal recovery and maintains nutritional status. Even in acute diarrhea, there is 70% nutrient absorption overall, so milk feeding must be continued. A little older children, say about 1.5 to 2 years, may not be satisfied with ORS alone. They should, in addition, be given other home available fluids like rice water, dal water, buttermilk, coconut water, lemon water and plain water as per their liking. But avoid soft drinks, aerated drinks and sweetened fruit drinks. This was plan A treatment for a child with no dehydration or minimal dehydration. Now we will come to a child with mild to moderate dehydration who will need the plan B treatment. The child must be under doctor's observation for first 4 hours. 80 ml per kg body weight ORS should be given during these 4 hours. Make the mother and the child sit in the clinic and feed it. If after 4 hours the child is fine and the signs of dehydration have disappeared, then you may send the child home with proper instructions. ORS should be continued in the dose of 50 ml per kg for next 24 hours plus 50 to 100 ml for each watery stool. An average of 1 teaspoonful or 5 ml should be given every minute. But if after 4 hours the child still shows dehydration, then the child should be admitted and we may have to opt for treatment plan C. Let me stress again that in infants, breastfeeding must be continued irrespective of the degree of dehydration. And in addition to ORS, plain water and breast milk must be given. However, if the child is vomiting excessively or if there is abdominal distension, then oral feeding becomes difficult. And without hesitation, start IV fluids, start Ringer's lactate. Also, if dehydration is not corrected or increases in spite of oral fluids due to continuous loose motions, then also IV fluids must be started. Lastly, if the child has severe dehydration, is lethargic with deeply sunken eyes and loss of skin turgor and scanty urine, then we should shift to plan C. This child should be referred to a pediatrician. Start IV fluids immediately and give Ringer's lactate. IV should be given fast and 30 ml per kg body weight Ringer lactate should be given in the first hour. Then give 15 ml per kg every hour for 4 to 5 hours so that in the first 6 hours 100 ml of fluid per kg should enter the body. Assess the baby after every 50 ml fluids and continue Ringer's lactate till eyeballs become normal, skin becomes turgid and sunken fontanel becomes flat. Usually 150 to 400 ml of Ringer's lactate is required. Once the skin becomes turgid, stop Ringer's lactate and start Isolite P and continue Isolite P 100 ml per kg in the next 24 hours. As soon as the child is alert, feeding of ORS and breastfeeding should continue. But let me warn you once again, if the child is listless or unconscious, dehydration is severe, if pulse is feeble or respiration is deep and sighing, then do not waste time. Take the child to a pediatrician immediately.